Hi and welcome back to Do-It-Yourself CNC Zone. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to build a cheap and strong linear bearing rails. The materials you need are a metal strip, 30 mm wide and 3 mm thick. An aluminium tube with 20 mm in diameter. A square centimeter aluminium tube. 4 20 mm rail block. Rivnuts, M4 bolts, spacers and nuts. There is no need for a special tool for the rivnuts as you can make one yourself. If you want to know how, take a look at my dedicated video about it.
In the first part of this video, we will focus on the tube.
Okay, let's get started. The most important thing is that the holes we are going to drill in the 20mm aluminium tube are in a perfect straight line. Any deviation will result in serious problems for the gantry to move. To prevent this from happening, I made a simple but very effective and self-aligning fixture. The first thing we need to is to drill a hole. A little piece of painter's tape prevent the drill from drifting. It is important that you drill on the real top of the tube. With help of my hammer, I mount the rivnut.
Please don't forget to like this video and hit the subscribe button. We do appreciate if you would leave a comment too. Thank you.
Once this is done, I can mount the first bolt into the tube. At this moment, the tube is already in the self-aligning fixture. I slide the tube further into the fixture so the bolt will go into the notch. Now the tube is automatically aligned so the next hole comes in a straight line with the first one. Just repeat this process until you drilled all the necessary holes. As you see here, this technique provides very satisfying results.
Great. The first part is finished. Now we will focus on the square tube.
I'll put some drill marks on the square tube. These marks represent the center of the rivnut so I can connect the two tubes easily. The column drill is centered so I will drill in the middle of the square tube. As I later need to mount it to the round one, I will drill through the square tube. As the hole is too small for the head of the screw, I need to make one hole bigger. And as you will see, the screw fits in perfectly now, which enables me to mount the round tube on the square one.
Well, that is great. As we finish the preparation of the square tube too, we are now able to connect both tubes.
The round tube is placed in a fixture. The M4 20mm screw that will connect both tubes will not be tightened 100% at this moment. You will notice that the bigger hole was not always aligned correctly. This is not a big issue as the screw will go back to the rivnut's position immediately after the head went through the hole. Once all the screws are mounted, I will first tighten every fifth screw. Then every third and so on. This method tribute to a better end result as there is less chance for unacceptable deviations. As a result of that, you will end up having a very nice straight linear rails. Well, you can see it and decide for yourself.
Now the tubes are mounted together, we can test the functionality of the linear bearing rails.
Do you remember this? If there should be any deviation, it will affect how smooth the bearing will run. Because of the increased resistance, you should hear difference in sound as well. Well, this sounds perfect to me.
Well, that is great news. Now we can start to work on the last part of the linear bearing rails, the footer.
Using a center punch, I am punching small markings for the drill. This enables the drill to start stable and doesn't search for the right spot. Now I can drill the outside holes in the footer. By mounting them first, it will become easier to align the footer correctly to the square tube. I am using blind rivets to connect the footer with the square tube. Once the alignment is good, it is no problem to mount just the next blind rivet. And finally, I can show you the self-made DIY linear bearing rails. It is not mounted yet, it will be as soon as the gantry is ready for mounting.
I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. Please don't forget to like this video and hit the subscribe button. We do appreciate if you would leave a comment too. Thank you.